Hi, this is JB from Not the Lights Over Arkham. This time I will be playing Barkham Horror, the Meddling of Mewlaphotep scenario with Jaqueline Canine. And because I can't build the deck in Arkham DB or anywhere else, I have to go through the deck in the old-fashioned way. So here is the deck laid out on the mat. So we are playing Jaqueline Canine. Trying to get it to focus, yeah. So Jaqueline is a mystic and has a good willpower and a decent intellect, but not that good of a fight or agility. Her special power is to bury one card beneath her as a fast triggered ability, and then to draw a card. So she will be cycling through her deck quite fast. As an action, you can dig up one of the buried cards or two of the buried cards, so they return into your hand, and the Elder Sign effect is +1. Dig up a buried card, returning it to your hand. As a special deck building, she is basically a mystic, except you can include cards level 0 to 5 with cat pictures in them or that are cats, which is a blasphemy, but it is still interesting. And other than that, you can have level 0 to 5 mystic cards and level 0 to 5 neutral cards. So, let's look at the cards that are from the Mystic class first. So, we have basic cards that stock Mystics use often, like Drawn to the Flame, Sixth Sense, Shriveling, Azure Flame, Ward of Protection. Promise of Power has become a staple card, and then I included a bit rarely now used cards like Stargazing that I used to use a lot but haven't used that much. And for economy, I added the Voice of Ra just for the laugh of it. I was debating with some other cards, but I ended up on those. In the basic leveled up cards or basic cards, I wanted to try out the Hemispheric Map. So the Hemispheric Map is not usually that good, but because I'm playing the Barkham Horror scenario, it has a lot of locations that are connected on all sides. So the when at least four other locations are connected will trigger a lot with this map. So we will be getting +2 willpower and +2 intellect from the Hemispheric Map, which is really a nice way to boost up the the mystic powers of Jaqueline. Then of course having cats in the deck is a necessity, so Stray Cat is a necessary card. Then we have the kind of an upgrade of Stray Cat I usually have in a deck with Stray Cats, so Miss Doyle and her cat army. And I haven't played with the Black Cat, so I decided to add the Black Cat also into the deck. And as I was going through all of the cards for that are released so far for Arkham Horror, I didn't find that many cards with cats in them. But one surprising card was the Truth Beckons. So at first I didn't even notice the cat, but there is a cat over there on the porch railway there. You can see it. So I added two of the Truth Beckon cards into the deck, and they actually work quite well in the map of Barkham, because you have a lot of locations, so you might go to the other end of the map and then need to go to the other end. So with the Truth Beckons, you can move quite fast across the board. The deck is a 29 experience deck, so we have two extra basic weaknesses. We hit Paranoia, then we hit Dread Curse, so we will be seeing some curse tokens in the game. Well, we have the Promise of Power too, so addition to those. Then we have the Day of Reckoning, which will seal an Elder Sign token on it until the agenda advances. So nothing that bad, but that Elder Sign sealing could be annoying. I also added two Charismas into the deck because we really want the Black Cat and Miss Doyle in play at the same time, and possibly Stray Cat too. But we'll see how it goes. That is basically the deck. I'll still show the signature cards. So we have the Chew Toy of Nightmares. Nightmares, I tell you. So Jaqueline Canine deck only. You may commit buried cards to skill test as if they were in your hand. So if you get this into play, I can tuck like skill cards or cards with good icons underneath Jaqueline and draw more cards and still use those skill cards to commit them to the tests. And then we have no sense of space or time weakness. So revelation, oh no, you forgot where you buried all of your cards. For each card you have buried, either take one horror or discard it. So basically that can wipe out all of the tucked cards under Jaqueline, so we need to be mindful of not overusing her ability. But that's basically the deck. I will set up the scenario and we'll get started, so let's get going. Okay, so we are ready to start, and per the setup I managed to find out that we are starting in Slubber Town here, and there is one clue and a Shroud of Three and a fast trigger ability, spend two resources. Barkham has no leash laws. You take yourself to a walk, move to Snout Side, group limit once per round. So we can pay two resources, move three action here, and that is it. We'll draw our opening hand, so I have pre-shuffled decks. Let's see what we get. Well, we reshuffle Day of Reckoning. We get Azure Flame, Hemispheric Map, Chew Toy of Nightmares, Sixth Sense, and Sword Cane. So actually I'm keeping the whole hand because we have everything we need right here. So I'll just shuffle the weakness back into the deck. I think I'm just setting up the first turn. Maybe investigating as a second action, but let's see. In all a good start. We really need some clues to get going. So we have of Cats and Dogs, Agenda 1A. You are hot on the trail of a cat conspiracy, a catspiracy if you will. Fast triggered ability, investigator at a location that is lousy with cats. Spend two clues per investigator as a group. Add the card beneath that location to the victory display. Action, if you are at the location that is lousy with cats, flip the card beneath that location over and spawn it at that location exhausted. So we need to get rid of these cards underneath these locations. So these six locations here are lousy with cats. And we have Act 1A, 9 lives. Dogs all across town report seeing struggle. Strange cats prowling around several locations in Barkham. Perhaps if you investigate these areas, you can root out the cat monsters that dwell within objective at the start of the investigation phase. No locations are lost and gets advanced. So immediately when we remove the card underneath these locations, they become not lost with cats. Okay, well, let's get started. I think I'm playing the Tutor of Nightmares down right as a first action. Second action, I think I'll play Sixth Sense. And we don't have any more resources, so I'll keep the rest and investigate. I investigate using the Sixth Sense. So, investigating 5 versus 3. And it's a plus 1, so we grab this clue. That is our turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep. We draw stray cat and gain one resource. So that was the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. Encounter card for this turn is Hunted by Biocats. Revelation: put Hunted by Biocats into play in your threat area. As at an additional cost to perform any of the following actions: move, fight, or investigate, you must spend one resource in cat food to appease the pursuing Biocats. Forced at the end of the turn, test intellect 3. If you succeed, discard Hunted by Biocats. So, let's see. Move, fight, or investigate. So, I think we are setting up. So, I think I'm using this space to put the cards that are underneath Jaqueline, so I don't have to lift the investigator card up all the time. So I'm burying the stray cat. And actually I think I'll keep the cards showing, so I don't have to flip them all the time. And we'll draw one card, and that's a fast action. Okay, well, I'll use the two resources to play the hemispheric map. As a first action. And second action. That's actually the last action with two, because it takes two actions. We'll move, so I'll move to snout side. And it's a one shard location with one clue. And a fast triggered ability. Spend two resources. You chase a delivery truck to the north. Move to tail side. Group limit once per round. So we can spend two resources to move to tail side from here. And that is our turn. We have to test the intellect test of 3 to get rid of the Hunted by Biocats. Actually, okay, I mistake this as a frozen in fear, so second action will take one resource and last action will move, so we have to pay one to move, so that's okay. So I will test, and we have the hemispheric map in play, so we have a intellect of 5 because we have 4 connecting locations. So I'm testing 5 versus 3 to get rid of this Hunted by Biocats. And it's a cultist, it's a minus 2. If you fail, place one doom on the nearest enemy, but we didn't fail. So we get rid of this Hunted by Biocats. That's our turn. Enemy phase, no enemies, we go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get Ward of Protection. Oh yeah, and these are my binded cards, so if you're wondering what this stack of cards here is, so there are the Stars Are Right and Hope, Seal and Augur. Just keeping them there. Okay, then we gain one resource and that is our turn, so let's go to the next turn. We add a doom the encounter card for this turn is Squirrel. It is a squirrel, you must chase it, test agility 4, for each point you fail by, lose one action. And I'm actually trying to not lose all of my actions. Or we could actually... Yeah, because we have a bad agility, I think I'm worth a protection in this. So, actually I'll put this over here. So... I'll ward of protection it. We take one horror. And we don't chase the squirrel. And yeah, that was the middle space. We don't have any cards to play at the moment, so I'm just investigating. Actually, I'll... Yeah, I'm not bearing any cards at the moment, so I'm investigating 5 versus 1 here. It's a cultist, it's a minus 2, so we grab this blue. Then, second action, let's just move down to the boneyard. And boneyard has 2 clues. Draw of 1. Triggered ability. After you successfully investigate boneyard by 2 or more, place 1 resource on boneyard as a bone. What did you expect? Action if there are 1 bones per investigator on boneyard. Nice, that's a lot of bones. Remove them and remember that you buried the bones a few meters from the where you found them. Okay, well, I think first thing we do is to trigger this fast action, so investigators at a location that is lousy with cats spend 2 clues per investigator as a group, add the card beneath that location to the victor display. So I'm spending these clues, then we add this card to the victor display, and it is the Hisser in the Dark, and I'll just put it over here. It's in the victory display, so we don't have to worry about that enemy anymore. Last action, we'll just investigate here. So I'm investigating, and we have 2 connecting locations, so we have a plus 1 to our intellect, so I'm investigating 6 versus 1. Yeah. So it's a minus 4, so we still succeed. But let's see, 6 versus 1 minus 4, so we don't actually succeed by enough, so we don't get to bury the bones, so to speak, here. That is left for the next round. No other actions, so no enemies. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, we find Miss Doyle, and we gain 1 resource. Okay, well, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom. We are at 3 of 4 Doom. Encounter card is... Rodent Killer. Okay. Rodent Killer is a 3/5/3 health 3 weight humanoid cultist. Prey investigator nearest to a card that is lousy with cats hunter. Okay, so it spawns on us, unfortunately. And we are in a bit of a pickle here. So I think I am taking 1 attack of opportunity. So we take 1 damage and 1 horror to get a resource. Second action, we'll use those 2 resources. Play the Sword Cane. And we immediately trigger the Sword Cane. So I am evading the rodent killer. 6 versus 3. And it is minus 5, woof, so we fail. Last action, really bait again. 6 versus 3. And it's a 0, so we managed to evade this rodent killer. And that is unfortunately our turn. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep. This guy readies. He engages us again. And we draw a card. We hit paranoia. Discard all of your resources. Well, lucky we didn't have any resources, so after that card we gain one resource. So that's that weakness quite well there. Okay. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda, so the agenda advances. So, cats out of the bag. The summoning is complete. Now one of the myriad nukes of Mewlaphotep crawls the streets of Barkham. It is up to you to put an end to this menace before its true master is unveiled. No locations are lousy with cats, advance to agenda 2-8. If at least one location is lousy with cats, find the one that is farthest from all investigators, flip the card beneath that location over and spawn it at that location. Reset this agenda back to agenda 1-8. So we remove the doom. And the farthest location is Velma's doghouse. So we spawn the mewling hunger to Velma's doghouse. It's a 2 fight 5 health 2 evade humanoid muse elite hunter. This enemy gets plus 1 health per investigator, so it's 6 health. If you scored some tasty food parlay, the hungry twins have been pleased, placated. They curl up happily in a box and fall asleep. Add this enemy to the victory display. Okay, so those nasty looking twin cats spawn there. Okay, well, then we still need to resolve the encounter card for this turn. And it is stubborn cat. Attached to the location in play with the most clues. A cat is laying on all of the evidence at this location. You obviously cannot investigate at that location. Test will 4 or agility 4 to shoo the cat away. If you succeed, discard stubborn cat. So there is that problem now. So I think the first action we will do is to sword cane the rodent killer. So I'm evading. 6 versus 3. It's a tablet and it's a minus 2, so I succeed. Second action. I think I am investigating here. No. Let's think about it. I'll bury the Azure. No. I'm just saving up for Mr. I don't need no more cards. So I'm testing the willpower test. So 6 versus 4 to get rid of the stubborn cat. And it's a minus 2. So we get rid of this. Last action will investigate 1. 6 versus 1. And it's a plus 1. So we grab this clue. And we also place one bones counter here. Enemy phase. This enemy hunts here. Upkeep, this guy readies. Engages us again. we draw a card, we get the Voice of Ra, and we gain one resource. So, nice, we start to get some resource generation going. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom, so 1/4. The agenda card, the encounter card rather, is an estranged cat. Spawn any empty location. Paused. After a strange cat enters play, place one Doom on it. When an estranged cat would be defeated, it runs away to the discard pile, but isn't injured at all. Please, I'm not a monster. It's 3 fight, 1 health and 2 evade creature. So I think because we are heading to the animal hospital this turn, we'll place it over there. And let's see, we place one Doom. And then we need to counter on there. That is the Mythos phase. So, investigation phase. We will Sword Cane the Rodent Killer. And it's a skull, and it's X is half of the number of Musk enemies in play, so it is 1. So we pass, and this Rodent Killer is evaded. Second action, we'll move to St. Mary's Animal Hospital. And it is a 3-star location with 2 crews. Yeah, action heal 3 damage, you're not happy about it, so limit once per game. And action take 1 damage, parlay, test, intellect 4, to schedule a visit to the vet for a cat. This is physically painful for you. If you succeed, remember that a cat has an appointment with the vet. Okay. So 2 clues here. And this guy engages us. Last action will... What could we do? Well, I'll, as a fast triggered ability, spend the clues. So we'll get rid of this card underneath here. And it is the Pouncer in the Night. So it goes into the victory display. Then we are fighting 2 versus 3. Not very good odds. Actually, before we move, I'll backtrack a bit. So this is just set up for next turn. So I'll play the Robes of Endless Night down, and then we'll move. So that is my whole turn. Next turn I can play the Azure Flame, or rather the Voice of Ra, without taking attacks of opportunity, and will be evading probably, or actually hitting with the Sword Cane. So that is the investigation phase, enemy phase. This moves here, and this hits us for 1, or and that is the turn. So upkeep with this guy readies. Sword Cane readied already, and we draw a card, we get the Promise of Power, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom here. Encounter card for this turn is Scratching Paws. Test agility 3. For each point you fail by, take 1 damage. So I'll bury this Promise of Power under myself and draw a card. I get the Truth Beckons. Then I'll use the two Toy of Nightmares to play the Promise of Power. So we add one curse token into the back. And I am testing 6 versus 3 for the scratching force. And it's a 0. So, and look at how adorable those scratching paws are. So we don't take any damage from that. So first action, I'll use the sword cane to hit the unfortunate strange cat. So we are hitting 6 versus 3, so minus 2 hits, and this guy runs, doesn't die. Runs into the counter discard pile. And that is that, so next up I'll think I'll play Voice of Raw. Voice of Raw, I mean, and we reveal 3 random tokens from the Chaos Bag. So we get 1 resource plus. So 3 resources. No. So we didn't actually gain any extra resources, so that was a bummer. And I'll move up here. So the rodent killer doesn't catch us with us yet. And it's Mutskatonic University. It's a 4-drop location with 1 blue. Action draw 3 cards, limit once per game. And action discard cards from your hand with a total of at least 3 intellect skill icons on them. Remember that you push rush on your cat physiology. Okay. And there is one clue here. And that is our turn. Enemy phase. I'll hunt this guy here and this guy here. Actually, I'll hunt this guy here. Because we have the Truth Beacons in hand, so we can slip past those guys. Okay. Well, that was the enemy phase. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get stargazing, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. Encounter card for this turn is Gaze of the Ceiling Cat. Test willpower 5. For each point you fail by, either lose 1 resource or choose and discard 1 card from your hand. If this effect forces you to lose all of your resources and discard all of your cards, you feel really creeped out. So I am testing 6 versus 5, and I really don't want to. Well, I'm tucking this underneath myself and drawing a card. Okay. I think I'm committing this to the test. So 7 versus 7 versus 5. It's a minus 1, so we don't lose any cards or resources. So that is that. And first action, we'll investigate here. So I'm investigating 6 versus 4. It's an auto fail. I don't have enough actions to try again. So I'll play the Truth Beckons. So it costs one. Play only if you are not engaged with an enemy. Move. Choose an unrevealed location. I'll choose the Beastern. Move one location at a time along the shortest path towards that location until you enter that location. End this effect if you reveal a location, if an enemy engages you, or your movement is blocked. So we move 1, 2, 3, and that is the shortest route. And Beast Town has two shroud, one clue, fast trigger ability, spend two resources. You follow a weird scent heading south, move to Slapper Town, group limit once per round. And the last action will move to Barkham City Pound. And that is a two shroud location, a three shroud location with two clues. And moving this over, yeah. And that is our turn. Enemy phase. This guy hunts here. This guy hunts here. Upkeep. We draw a card. We get another six cents, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We advance the agenda again, so the same thing happens as last time. We reveal the card beneath a location that is farthest from us, and it is this one. And we get the Dweller in the Deep. Don't ask how. 3 fight, 3 health, and 2 evade. Monster Musk Elite, Alert Hunter. This enemy gets plus 1 health per investigator, so it has 4 health. Action: if you brush up on cat physiology, parley, you inform the Dweller in the Deep that this has no gills and therefore cannot breathe underwater. The universe self-corrects for the paradox and the Dweller in the Deep ceases to exist. Add it to the victory display. Okay, well, let's place that guy there. And we get an encounter card. And it is scratching paws again. So I'm actually committing Stray Cat to the test. So I'm testing 3 versus 3. Actually, let's not do that yet. I'll tuck the Sixth Sense underneath myself as a free action and get Shriveling. Okay. Then I will commit the Stray Cat to the test. So 3 versus 3. It's a minus 1. So we take 1 damage and I'll place it on the Robes of Endless Night. Okay, and that is the Mythos phase. I think we are playing Miss Doyle as a first action. So we shuffle the cat army. And we get Ogre. And Ogre helps us investigate. I rather would have wanted to see the evade one, but it is what it is. Okay, and that was our first action. Second action, we'll investigate. I'm investigating 6 versus 3. It's an Elder Sign. I'll get this card back into my hand and succeed. And the last action, I will move. I'll move to Velma's Doghouse. So Velma Store has a two shroud location with two clues. Action parlay test. Willpower 5. You beg and beg and beg. If you succeed, remember that you scored some tasty food. You also take some for yourself. Deal 1 damage and 1 horror. So we'll definitely try that next turn. Because we also need that to defeat the Mewling Hunger. Okay, and that is our turn. Enemy phase. These guys hunt here. This guy hunts. Let's go here. And that is that turn. Upkeep. We draw a card. We hit the Dread Curse. So that makes us our life a bit harder. So we add 5 curse tokens into the chaos pack. Okay. That is the. Oh yeah, and we get 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. Encounter card for this turn is Servant of Dogsotos. Spawn. Occasion with the most enemies, including face down encounter cards. Alert, retaliate. So the occasion with the most enemies is actually south side. So we'll place that. And the face down enemies. We could spawn also over here, but we really don't need to go here anymore. At least I think so. So we'll spawn this guy over here. And it doesn't have hunter, so let's check. So Servant of Dogsoto 2, fight 4, health 2, evade. And monster cut abomination. Alert, retaliate, yeah. So it just hangs over there. And that is the mythos phase. We go to the investigation phase. I will first action. I'm actually first action. No. First, we tuck this sixth sense underneath ourself and draw a card. We get the Azure Flame. We have all the combat spells, but I'm not gonna do any fighting at the moment. So we will try the willpower test here. Testing 6 versus 5. So we need to succeed, then hopefully move and parlay that enemy. So minus 1. I'll just mark that we have done this. Second action, we'll move here. Oh yeah, and we heal 1 damage and 1 horror because we succeeded. We move here, this engages us, and let's see. So action, if you scored some tasty food, parlay, the hungry twins have been placated. They curl up happily in a box and fall asleep. So we add this into the victory display. And that is 3 of 6 Musk enemies down. And we go to the enemy phase. So this and this guy hunt here. Then upkeep, we draw a card, we find the black cat, and we gain 1 resource. So I'm definitely playing the black cat down next turn, possibly. And I think that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, encounter card is Musk of Mewlaphotep. Revelation, if Mewlaphotep is in play, well it isn't yet. If at least one location is loose with cats, choose one of those locations, flip the card beneath that location over and spawn it at that location. If neither is true, this card gains search. So we have to choose one location if it's loose with cats. I think it's this one, because this is the then the last location loose with cats, and we can investigate and get rid of this card. And I think then we advance, so we'll flip this over. And we see the ghost cat. Cat that is also a ghost. Creature, Musk Elite. 2 fight, 2 health and 4 evade. Alert Hunter. This enemy gets plus 1 health for each investigator. Action, if you buried the bones a few meters from here, where you found them, parlay. Oh, that's what those were. Well, that's sad. Still, the cat spirit is appeased. At this enemy, the victor display, so I'm a bit annoyed that I didn't do that when I had the chance, but I didn't really have the actions to do it at that moment, so spawn this guy over here in the Barkham Asylum. And let's see. Then that was the Mythos phase, so first action we will play the Black Cat. Actually, I'll tuck one of the shrivels and draw a card. I get the hair of the dog. Well, that is actually quite good pull for this. So, hair of the dog. Barkham deck only. Max 1 committed per skill test. After this skill test ends, the investigator performing this test gets minus 2 skill value for the next skill test that they perform this round. So, I'm keeping on to that. But second action, I am definitely investigating here. And it is 6 versus 3. It's a minus 1. We grab this clue. And we'll spend these 2 clues here to get rid of this card. And it is the cat riding a Baya cat. So we add it to the victory display. Let's check it. At the start of the investigation phase, if no location allows, it gets advanced, so we still don't advance. And what should we do with our last action? I think I'm taking one resource. Yeah. And that is the investigation phase. Enemy phase. This hunt here. This hunt's here. And we go up. Upkeep, so we draw a card, we get drawn to the flame, and gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 3 of 4 doom, and counter card for this turn is. It's the Order Cultists. 4 fight, 2 health, and 1 evade. Humanoid sort of cultist, definitely. Spawn any empty location, retaliate. Post at the end of the Mythos phase, place 1 doom on Order Cultist. So we, at the end of the Mythos phase, place this, so doesn't advance the agenda. But we need to place it somewhere. So I think I'm placing it over to Velma's doghouse. We could leave it there this turn. Okay, well, we will advance the act. So, the Prowling Chaos. Spawn the Azathoth Mewlaphotep enemy at the central location of your choice. For each Musk enemy in play, attach that enemy face down to Mewlaphotep. Now Mewlaphotep is the one who is lousy with cats. Advance to Act 2A and Agenda 2A. So, the cat and the mouse. There must be a way to destroy this cat's abomination for good. Maybe catnip, a cardboard box. A length of string. Action. Spend one clue. Deal 2 damage to an enemy at your location, or 1 damage without provoking attacks of opportunity. Objective. If Mewlaphotep is defeated, advance. And Mewlaphotep is... Well, let's look at the agenda first. So we advance this. So this go away. So we have Mewlaphotep's scheme. The prowling chaos treads upon the earth once more. Its hiss shakes the foundation of the city. Its screech shatters windows and rends living creatures whole. Its purr, well, okay, its purr is pretty adorable, but everything else is really bad. So, 8 Doom Threshold, so we don't have that long of a time to resolve with that. And this and this enemy gets removed. So these are placed underneath, so... See here. So, Mewlaphotep, Muser of the Outer Gods. 3 fight, 4 helper. Investigator, 3 evade. Ancient, 1 elite. Hunter, Mewlaphotep gets plus 1 health for each Musk enemy attached to it, so it has 6 health. Mewlaphotep gets plus 1 fight and plus 1 evade for every 2 Musk enemies attached to it, so it is actually 4 fight. 6 health and 4 evade. While there are 3 or more Musk enemies attached to it, Mewlaphotep gains retaliate and alert. Well, lucky it doesn't have that much. And these are all central locations, so to buy us some time. I think I'm spawning Mewlaphotep over. Let's think about this. We'll go defeat that guy. This guy moves here, this guy moves here. Next turn we go there, then move there, and yeah. Okay. So we'll spawn it over here, tail side. And that is the start of our turn. We'll go to. Can actually grab those clues in Velma's diner with the drone to the flame. Be a bit risky, but yeah. So first action, we'll move here. This enemy engages us, and we'll exhaust the Robes of Endless Night to play. Should we play? Come playing the Shriveling. And last action, I will shrivel this. So this Robes of Endless Night removes the attacks of opportunity from this. So I'm attacking, and I'm tucking this underneath and drawing a card so I get Promise of Power. I'm actually using the Promise of... No, I'll use the... Because this is the last action, the Hair of the Dog. So we are... Let's put the charges on here. So I'm using the Shriveling to attack. So I'm attacking 6 versus 4. Plus 4, so 10 versus 4. It's a minus 5. So we still hit and kill off this enemy. And that is our turn, and we actually took, let's see, so I can choose to use the ability on the black cat to turn it into a minus one. The black cat takes one direct horror, but I won't use that, I'll just take the horror on black cat Actually, take the horror on Miss Doyle. And now that I know this, these two cats look quite similar, but I think they're different cats. And this really doesn't take up an ally slot, but I keep it there because I don't have another space for it at the moment. And yeah, that is the investigation phase. We'll go to the villain, the enemy phase. So this guy hunts here, this guy hunts here, and that is that turn. We'll go to upkeep, we draw a card, we find seal, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. Encounter card for this turn is, don't be an enemy. It's on your tail. If there are no enemies in play, on your tail gain search. Otherwise, place one doom on the enemy nearest to you and test agility X, where X is that enemy's evade value. If you fail, that enemy attacks you. So this rodent killer gets one doom, and we are testing. So I'm just testing. I'm not even committing. Well, I'll put this, bury this promise of power on myself and draw a card, and we get the robes of endless night, which I'll actually commit that to the test. So I'm testing 3 versus, I'll commit seal, so 4 versus 3 sounds good. Okay, so minus 5, woof. Okay, so now we can take a direct horror on black cat, and this is minus 1, so we pass this test, so this guy doesn't attack us. And that is the Mythos phase. Investigation phase, we will draw into the flame, draw one encounter card, hunted by a cat. Okay, so move, fight, investigate costs more actions, that is totally fine. We grab these two clues. We'll move, pay one. And it is the Barkham Asylum. One clue there, rather four. And that is our turn, so enemy phase. The last action. Yeah, I'll just take one resource. Okay, so enemy phase, this guy hunts here. This guy hunts here. So we are engaged with the Mewlaphotep, and we take 2 damage and 2 horror. I'll take the horror on myself. I'll take the damage on you, this Doyle and the black cat. And that is the enemy phase, so upkeep. We draw a card, we get the hair of the dog, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, and counter card for this turn is a strange cat, any empty location. So just spawns there. Next into the tail side, for example, and gets one doom on it. Okay, so this turn I think we are trying to kill off Mewlaphotep. So first action, I'll place the hair of the dog underneath myself to draw a card. We get the sword cane. Then I'll use the shriveling. So I'm attacking. Mewlaphotep is 4 attack so, or four combat, so I'm attacking five, six versus four, but I'll use the Hair of the Dog and the Promise of Power. So we add one curse token into the back. I am attacking 6, 10, 14 versus 4. So we need to hit quite many curse tokens to not hit. So we get a 0. So we deal 2 damage. And Mewlaphotep had plus 1 health for each Musk enemy. So 6 damage we need to deal. So I'll spend one clue to deal 2 damage. Then we take an attack of opportunity. The Robes of Endless Night break. And I'll take 1 damage. Then I'll take 1 horror here, 1 horror here. And last action. We'll spend the last clue we have. We deal 2 damage, but before that we take 2 attacks of opportunity hits. And Miss Doyle and the Black Cat get defeated by Horror. I'll actually put the damage on the Black Cat too. And that is the end of the scenario, so we managed to deal enough damage on Mewlaphotep. So let's advance. So if Mewlaphotep is defeated, advance. Void by dogs. As the entity known as Mewlaphotep collapses, its body dissolves into the shadows from where it emerged. You know that one day the order of dead rodents on the doorstep will try to revive them on their master once more. But for now, at least, Barkham is safe. You let out a fierce howl to let the rest of the dogs in the city know of your victory. Within moments, the sky is filled with the triumphant howls of dogs everywhere. All across Barkham, humans look on in confusion, thinking, why is my dog acting weird? Resolution 1. The humans will never know the danger that lurks just beyond the edges of their senses. The danger they could not smell despite its false scent. You will stay alert and loyally sniff out any hazards to your beloved city, for that is the duty and burden you and all dog kind bear. But until the next time you are needed, you are content to sleep, play and eat treats after treats. Victory is sweet. The investigators win, but only if they too are dog people. Well, I am. Cat people complete the scenario successfully, but feel like traitors. Okay, well, that was the Meddling of Mewlaphotep with Jaqueline Canine, and I was quite happy how the deck worked, and well, happy that we didn't we would have hit the Day of Reckoning quite soon, and a couple of cards from that, the No Sense of Space and Time. But other than that, we basically got everything we needed from the deck. And the deck worked quite good for this scenario. And the well-timed Truth Beckons really came in useful in this scenario. I had my doubts on this card, but for specific scenarios, I think this is a okay card, even in true solo. So, hope you guys liked this playthrough. Let me know if you want to see more Barkham Horror playthroughs in the future. I think I can play with all of the Barkham investigators in true solo at some point. So, thanks for watching, and until next time.